Gearhart's back.
The more things change, the more they stay the same.
From NJ1015.com, this is the new Jim Gearhart Podcast.
Here we go. Bob Williams, Jim Gearhart, the day after the big election that was supposed to be the great turning point of history.
And I guess it was, if you're the happy Democrat, right?
Well, I'm not sure about that. Let us start off here by celebrating the American institution of this election. I think that's what it turned out to be. This I tell you, I got up this morning and I was listening and looking around for results. I was terribly disappointed, not by the election result, but by the fact that it was just so ordinary. I wanted something exciting.
Right.
Either this is going to shoot down the progressives, or it's going to shoot down the Trumps and the blue wave. Remember the blue wave?
Yep. Now you can call us Blue Jersey, right?
Well, it's Blue Jersey. Yeah, they had a map. Our news department here had a map. And I think Burlington County, parts of Burlington County, and parts of Mercer were the only red in the state.
And what were you saying for years about the last person in New Jersey? Well, I guess we can say, will the last Republican in New Jersey please turn out the lights?
Yeah, the last Republican to leave New Jersey, please turn out the
lights. That's going to be Chris Smith.
Well, Chris Smith. Yeah, Chris Smith was elected. Chris Smith has been the Republican congressman from the 4th District, which I think is a little bit of Burlington, mostly Mercer County.
Right.
What, 30 years?
Right, pretty much.
You know why? What it's laid to?
No.
He has outstanding constituent service. He sort of stays himself in the background. You don't hear much about Chris Smith.
Right.
But boy, does he has offices all over the district, and his people work with people, and they love him.
Mm-hmm.
Should be assigned to others, but a
couple of those guys just lost their seats. Leonard Lance up north.
Well, he retired.
No. Frelinghuisen.
Oh, Frelinghuisen retired.
But Leonard Lance, he
should have.
He pretty much
may as well have.
Yeah, right.
The results we're talking about the blue wave, you know, and this was supposed to sweep over nationally. It did not happen. Because the Senate has stayed Republican.
Uh-huh.
Now, if you look back, Bob, and you can check this out, almost every election midterm election that ever was held in New Jersey, the party of the president, the incumbent, you know, ruling party, lost seats, and the other party gained seats. It even happened during the Clintons and the Bushes and for heaven's sakes, how quickly we forget. Ronald Reagan. And probably back to Chester A. Arthur.
Probably.
And it makes sense, because in a presidential election, the big job is the presidency. And this is where all the attention is, and so it has big coattails. So whoever loses the presidency or wins the presidency obviously had more people on his coattails.
Uh-huh.
And this trickles down to the lower offices. But then in a midterm election, there is no big exciting thing at the top.
Right.
And so people will go back to their usual roots, grumblings, or often indifference and say, well, different, you know, I'll push this button here. So it makes sense, but this has always happened. But now, this, I don't know what it means. Again, as I said, I was hoping, I guess it's just, as a member of the audience, it's just looking for something exciting.
Yeah.
And it wasn't here. You know the big loser in this election?
Who's that?
Was this area of the media that is so far out left and constantly hammering away at Trump, who are trying to make this a referendum on Trump,
right,
which in the case of some individuals it was, but not generally speaking. But you take the weight of media, which is the monopoly on how people get their information.
Yeah.
It's the only way. And it's all slanted one way, and yet they didn't pull off the blue wave. That, to me, is incredible. And it would show that people are not that much influenced by our news stars
right now.
Mm-hmm. I don't agree with the president saying that, you know, media is all bad and the enemy of the people. And like some media, I think he should qualify that.
Yeah.
And saying some members of the media, and then nobody would argue with that.
You're still here? Video's over. You can subscribe to our channel, click on the logo for more great content from New Jersey 101.5. Comment, share, click another video. This one's done.